Yo. It's weird starting off with no music, but what's up, guys? It's your boy, every motherfucking Cuban.
And it's your boy, I Am Good, and you back at it again with a new EP, man.
Hell yeah. I'm gonna just take a little break right now, just so I could get. Let me just get the music going.
I know you. So that's our man. That's the fucking. That's the fuel right there.
Let me just.
We need that feel. Yeah.
We gonna start rapping again, bro, or what?
Yeah, niggas was feeling our freestyle.
Hell yeah. Uh-huh. Hey, we got a special guest in the back too. My boy Timothy is in the house, but you don't want to be in the camera.
Yeah, he had a background audience right there.
Yeah. Mark, how you doing?
Oh, man, I'm chilling, man. It's been a busy day today, actually.
I know. I see you went to the fair and shit.
Yeah, I went to the fair, man. That's like a family tradition. It's something that I want to instill in my children, man. Like, as soon as the fair come around, like, they ask me, like, let's go. Like, and it's automatic.
I like the fair, but I don't like the fair.
Why?
It's just... a lot of fuck niggas in there.
Bro. <it's> like, man, they got comfort food in that motherfucker.
Nah. I don't know. Like, because I had bad experience. Like, the two times that I went, I just, like, didn't like it. It's just, like, it was hot.
Mm-hmm.
I was sticky. Like, I had a icy, and that shit, broke on me for, like, I don't know how, but it broke on me. And I had, a white tee. Mm-hmm. And the icy was, like, the rainbow.
Oh, so it was like die.
Yeah, bro. It just, I was walking, everybody just kept looking at me like, fuck. And the second time I went, I was not feeling good. I think I had like a hangover or something, and I had to go take my nieces. And I'm like, I have a video of it too. And I'm like,
Well, you know, the best one is the San Diego Fair.
Never been it.
Oh, you got to go to San Diego.
Only been to the OC Fair. I've been to the one that they put right here in Paris.
But they got one in Paris?
They used to.
What the fuck?
Right there by the racetrack.
Oh, no, I never knew about that. I've been living in Mobile what for the about fuck, nigga? 20 years, bro.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Let's pour some drink. Yeah, what you about to drink?
This was good. That one was good.
Shit, we need... This is empty.
So. You want me to kill the Japanese liquor?
Fuck it. Let's do that today, bro.
That shit's gross. That shit's going to stay there.
You didn't bring nothing to... You didn't bring nothing to chase it.
I know.
But fuck it. Shout out to Jackie.
I know. This shit...
Nasty ass shit.
This shit has, like, seawater in it. For real, this shit tastes like the sea.
Hell yeah, it's like nasty sushi.
Yeah, that shit is nasty.
I don't know why we did that, but I just got an update, guys. I don't have a mullet no more. That shit is gone. Did it today.
That nigga Manscaped.
Shout out to Manscaped, sponsor us, man. But that shit gonna. It was looking all right, you know what I'm saying? Long on the bottom.
Uh-huh.
I couldn't. Damn. But
did you already open it?
I already opened that one. I was already drinking. But by the way, we got a new bench.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so we got a new bench. Because we look like fucking sardines on that one.
Yeah.
Shout out to Abel for coming and showing us that we're not. You have to have, you know, I didn't put it in what's that word? I don't want to fuck it up. Hey, smart guy.
Perspective.
Yeah, there you go.
He was trying to get that bitch out. Well, I couldn't put it in perspective, so.
That we're two big niggas.
What is the order now? Like, okay, me and you sit there, and then.
So we could we could sit right here, and the guest there, or the guest could sit here, and then me and you could sit. But if we have three guests, you'll sit there. The guest here and I'm in here,
yeah,
or the other way around, you here, but you have to work the
That's the thing, like the guest have to turn your way then turn my way if he's sitting right here. So I think the best thing is probably for us to continue to sit right here and they just stay in that hot seat.
Oh yeah, you're right. You're
because
right.
They'll have to turn to you and then I got questions.
Right. Yeah, you're right. Yeah. That's what I was somebody at work was telling me that, and I'm like, nah, it's not the angle, because like if I had to talk to, if I, Mark was saying something, I was like, cause I was telling him, oh, no, you shouldn't do it because this and that. No, because like the mic sounds really clean.
Yeah. Crisp.
Crispy because, you know, I moved everything around, plugged everything back together. Mm-hmm. So, yes, sir. And so I was like, no, because when we did that podcast, I was going like this, talking to you.
Yeah, that was.
I didn't like that. So, and the only thing I didn't like about this setup is that, well, if you could tell, I moved the mic back. Yeah. Because it was right here, so I wouldn't be able to see you.
Yeah, that's true.
So, and then I can't get this one out no more. So that's just staying.
That should be like a little cup holder. Like,
hell no, because then we'll have another episode dropping that shit. Nah, brother. We got the little setup going.
Yeah.
You know,
that'll be legit, though.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so.
Or we could just have when two guests to come, they can just sit on that bench.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, the two guests will be like there, and I mean you there. Like, mm-hmm. It's still like, I mean, we don't. Well, I could still look at you, talk, and then look at them. So we should be solid.
That'd be straight.
Should be solid. So how was the fair though?
Oh man, the fair was good, man. I enjoyed. What's the rides.
What's your favorite thing to do there?
Oh shit, get comfort food, bro. The barbecue, brisket burger, fire.
Brisket burger, that sounds fire.
I had some, of course, fried Oreos. Some bacon wrapped shrimp. Chicken, that shit was fire, but that shit is expensive. You gonna go there and spend about $200-$300 for sure.
God damn, we can't do that.
Yeah,
we got we got collections up in this bitch.
You, because the tickets is what, $50 for 40 tickets. Once you go through that, yeah, and you go through that.
What do you mean 40 tickets?
40 tickets,
$50. Oh, because you have to pay for the.
Yeah, you gotta pay for the rides and shit. Sucks. And then the food is. You know, $15, $16. You want a drink, you know, you get a beer, that's $15. So, yeah.
But see, I don't like drinking at the fair because I don't know. I don't like drinking at baseball games, basketball games. I've never been to a basketball game. I don't know why I said that. Football games, because I feel like they do shit on purpose where, like, your beer gets hot fast. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So you have to drink that shit fast so you get another one. So my dumb ass, I went to go see the Red Sox. Shout out to the Red Sox, doing really good, actually doing pretty good. Oh, this shit.
I need to wear my LA hat. But,
And I bought two beers.
Yeah.
Right? So I bought two beers. I'm done. And then by the time I was done with this one was hot as fuck. And I wasn't even by the sun.
Mm-hmm.
I wasn't, like, the sun was hitting me, but it was like, it was still hot, but it was on my Liv's birthday. So it was like in the middle of the fucking summer.
Do you keep it in a cup holder? Like that they.
Hell no, I have it like this.
Nigga, I keep it under my chair.
Oh, that's smart.
It shades it, keeps it cool.
That's smart.
Nobody kicks it over.
I almost asked for a cup of ice, nigga. I was like, give me a cup of ice.
Oh, yeah.
But then, you know, Liddy makes me, like, this is what I hate. Liddy makes me look like a bitch sometimes.
Why?
Because, like, shit, like, when I got my tattoo, I wasn't going to get this in. Mm-hmm. And she's like, you're already here. Why'd you get it? And I'm like, bitch, because you're not getting it. I'm already hurt. I'm already hurting. And then that day, I was like, I think I'm going to go with a cup of ice. And she goes, why? Beer don't go with ice. And I'm like,
keep the shit cold.
but you know in Europe they drink the beer like warm.
Yeah,
that nasty. Shit is gross, but it fucks you up more though.
Does it?
Yeah, because one day, bro, like, me and shout out to my boy Johnny at Home Depot, that nigga said, I got 805s in the car, and I'm like, in the middle of the summer, bro. And I said, what? He's like, yeah, you want to drink them? I said, fuck it. I thought they were warm, nigga. I thought they were cold. Yeah, you can talk.
Yeah,
I thought they were warm, nigga. I'm like, I mean, cold. So I'm like, all right. So when he popped that shit, I seen like it went poof, and I just see smoke, and I'm like, So he gave it to me. That shit was hot. So I'm like, man, so I can't, you know, can't waste no alcohol.
Yeah.
So I took that shit down, bro. By the time I got to this light right here, nigga, I was feeling it. With one beer, I was like, oh shit.
That shit,
you right?
It don't set well with my stomach though.
Oh yeah, you pissed it right away. So we got a doctor in the house.
That makes a lot of sense. Hell yeah, nigga, wake up thirsty in the middle of the night, like, damn. I hate that shit.
That nigga choking in the middle of the night. Have y'all like ever fucked? Right, you fuck, and then you go to bed, and in the middle of the night you wake up thirsty as fuck because that shit hit you like. like you catch your breath in the middle of the night.
You
like you fuck really good and you go to bed, right? So you knock out.
Mm-hmm.
Like you don't even, like your dick is still, you know, still there. If you wear condom, yeah. If you see,
like, oh
if
shit.
If you wear a condom, the condom's like halfway out, and you just sitting like, and you wake up thirsty as fuck. I'm like, what the fuck? What just happened? You butt ass naked?
Because you just dehydrated after all the work you just put in.
And shit.
Mm-hmm.
You guys sweat when you guys smashing?
Yeah.
A lot or just a little bit? Yeah.
Low key. Yeah, so I'm like, yeah, I'm just letting it go now. Like, fuck it.
Like, I'll be like, look at I'm only putting two strokes in.
Oh, hell nah, bro.
That shit, like, you like fucking look like this is loop for your dick and shit.
All right. Serious question. Like, and this for the man out there, obviously. We do most of the work during sex, right?
Amen.
Do you think your woman should have, like a period of time where she just doing like most of the work where you can gain your energy and last longer?
Yeah, nigga. Second round.
Do you ever tell your girl that, like, hey, you got to do something right now?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
You don't?
No. I mean, she do it, but you it's know,
like,
I don't ask.
She does it, but it's like, ugh.
Yeah, it's kind of like, yeah, don't talk. My dick on the shelf, so I don't remember what it's like.
Nigga, I had to process that shit. I said, "What do we go? What?"
He done retired it. Like, fuck it. We just, man. I think like when you and your partner have sex, it's a mutual agreement. But like, of course, we men, we hornier, so we ask the woman like, "Hey, you want to have sex tonight?" And then when she turned like, nope. down, that's the. That's the most devastating shit, because it's just like, I don't want to have sex with you next time. Yeah.
That's true. I seen that before. No, but it is like, bro, like, literally, he said, why you get mad when I say no? I said, nigga, because my dick is already hard. Like, he said, wait, why is it hard before you ask me? And I'm like, because you come out naked and shit. Like, the fuck? Like, you don't think I'm just get hard? Like, the fuck? Like, and then she was like, oh, well, I don't understand why you get so mad. I'm like, because I'm trying to show you some love.
Mm-hmm.
And you're not trying to get it from me. So I had to go in the bathroom. I had to go in the bathroom and go down, do it myself. And it's not so much fun.
It's not.
Because I don't know. Like, after I got some, it was not the same. You know? It was not the same. My hand before I got some was the best thing in the world, right?
Yeah.
After you get some, you like stroke. You stroking that shit is not. That shit is like.
It's like you just
like, nigga, wake up. Shit. We used to do this shit together all the time.
I know. It's like you only do it just to get that, you know, of course, that feeling. You know what I'm saying? Like, you only look at porn now just to get that feeling. Like, you don't really get to enjoy porn as far as like, you know, like you was when you was in your teens. Like, you was surging through that motherfucker.
You would sit there for hours.
Yeah. Man. Shit. I'm fighting something, nigga.
Nigga, and then you remember, like, you see one, and it's like, oh, I'll be back. You remember that number? Oh, page two.
Oh man, yeah,
nah, but true that. I seen a it was a, like a little. I don't know if it was a study, but it was a topic.
Mm-hmm.
They saying like, the guy was like, if you have like, it was a podcast. He's like, if you have sons, and you like, you know, catch them doing that shit, tell them to do it for the pleasure, not for like, I just need a nut, because that if when you do it just to nut, like, that's how you. When you get it in, it's gonna you're not gonna last as long.
Yeah.
So if you do it to feel the pleasure of it, you're gonna like, okay, but when you just fucking jackrabbit that shit, then you, when you go in, you're gonna just jackrabbit everything. Damn, I was like, man, I wish somebody would have told me that when I was younger. Oh, you got a good 25 seconds. Hell yeah, shit. 25 seconds is I'm good, cause and then plus I have my mom in the room too. Cause like, so my mom rented my room out, so I had to sleep with my mom on the couch. So me and her shared the fucking bathroom. So when I was going in there, I'm like, man, I'm kind of horny. And like, my mom's watching a little soap operas, a little Mexican fucking novellas and shit.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, fuck, should I just do it or just wait until everybody's gone? And then I'll be in the bathroom, being there and shit. I'm like, are you almost out?
Nah,
hold on. I got to cut somewhere. I need to find it.
Oh,
to
shit.
Watch this bitch.
Nigga, living with Martell, he used to put my shit on blast, bro. That nigga know I was in there 45 minutes. Nigga, get out the bathroom. You jacking off, aren't you? Like, my mom, yeah, Mark, get out the bathroom. Oh, shit, fuck it. And fucked up my whole moment. Hell yeah.
Yeah, nah. You ever got caught?
Yeah.
I don't know if we ever talked about it.
I got caught. Yeah. I fucked around and put it in a computer.
What?
A DVD player in the computer.
Oh, no, I'm talking about
and I couldn't get the bitch out. No. No,
I was like, damn, you put it on the computer? Like, what the fuck? What kind of kinky shit
I'm
you were doing?
Myself,
my nigga said, my nigga did the OnlyFans. You started OnlyFans, nigga.
Nah, when a nigga didn't have a DVD player, I just used a computer, pop it in, and I couldn't get the bitch out. Somebody was like, what the fuck? Some porno panning on this motherfucker. Finally took it out. It was probably one of my dad's porns, but shit. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Damn,
it was a DVD.
My boy Frank's mom told everybody that we would go to his house and watch porno. Shit. And then my mom go like, "Do you watch porno?" And I'm like, "Yeah." Like, what the fuck? Like,
I'm a guy, so
she was like,
"It only makes sense."
Just be careful. And I'm like, "What?" And then when she said that, I thought I was about to get an STD or some shit. I'm like, "Be careful! What the fuck? Like, I could cash out them to watching this shit." But I didn't ask questions. I was just like, "Yeah, for sure." And then the next day, we were back at Frankie's house, fucking watching porno.
Oh, yeah. I was just about to get into that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would say like,
yeah,
when you're like when you're a married person, you go a long stints without having sex sometimes, like, you know, 1-2 couple weeks. Maybe a month, I don't know. But
I think you say months.
But it's a point in time where you and your woman are busy. She's at work, you at work, she cleaning the house, you doing outside yard work and shit like that. So I think I'm talking about the man. She cleaning the house and I'll do a yard work and shit like that. So I think like you kind of fill that void with not having sex and you just look at porn. So you just be like, fuck it, I don't need her right now. So let me just go and do my thing. Chicken. Yeah. I think that,
do you think
that kind of fucks up a relationship too, though?
Do you think so?
Uh-huh.
Well, I mean, watching porno?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yep. Definitely.
But I mean, if you watch porn like that, then if you're married and watching it a lot, then that's a problem. But if you once in a while, I think it should be good, right?
Yeah, you should be.
I'm like always checking myself, like, right. You guys agree, right?
I only do it a couple times a week. Nigga, fuck.
A couple times a day. Nah. I stopped. This is the reason why I stopped using Twitter or X.
Yeah, that's just all porn.
Bro, like, I'm like, every time I hop up, shit, like, especially at work when I'm like, oh, let me just check what people are saying or some shit. And the first thing pops up, somebody getting fucked up, like, ah, yeah, you know what?
And it's like, you don't even gotta follow the page. You can be somebody you follow and they
exactly.
They
share it or they literally gonna say, oh, you follow the page. And I was like, I don't. And then it was I could bleep her name. what the fuck was her name? She's some
porn star?
No, it's a friend. Yeah. No. She's our friend.
She got OnlyFans now?
I think so.
Yeah.
So she's the one that be posting, like, reposting shit. I'm like, the fuck? And then sometimes she's been like that since I
started. Yeah.
I'm like, what the fuck, Aaron? Mm-hmm. Oh, I'll cut that off.
Leave that out to you, nigga. Leave that out too, nigga.
I cut that off. But no, I'm like, what the fuck? Like, yo, like, why are you posting this shit? Like, so I just stopped using that shit because even like some of the homies, like, I'm like, bro, like,
that
boy is excessive.
Who? AD.
That boy is excessive. He'll let you know too. Like, look, I'm finna start liking all this.
I wanna have that nigga in here, though.
I know we gotta have that nigga on here. He's funny as hell.
I told that nigga that he's gonna be my stylist.
Oh yeah,
cause he had Daniel, he was dressed like the day of the fight. He told Daniel, he's like, damn, my boys looking good. So he's like, yeah, I dressed them. And I'm like, I was like, oh yeah, how much you charge? Like, nah, I got you, bro. I'm gonna be your stylist. I was like, yeah, for sure. Damn, nigga, you really killing that shit.
Yeah, I told you, nigga, I didn't.
Nah, kill that.
Oh shit, damn, I forgot what we were drinking.
Nigga, I don't know if I could drink this shit, bro.
I know.
That shit's not good. Twitter or something.
Just these OnlyFans chicks and,
yeah.
Like, they literally ruin social media.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, so yeah, look at my pussy. $5 off this month.
Man.
But I mean, that shit is crazy now. Like, you know, that sex is so like open.
Yeah.
I mean, I feel like when
we're America was suppressing it because when
Europe. Well, no, Europe is Germany. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Literally, Germany had condoms for sale in the bathroom.
Yeah.
In like little pocket pussies.
Yeah. What?
in the bathroom. So I'm like,
for free?
For free? You just go in the bathroom and beat your meat?
You gotta pay for it, but it's like.
Like you wait, why in the bathroom though? Like, you just go in the bathroom and beat your meat or what? With a pocket pussy?
Niggas in the bathroom like.
Man, I was in the airport bathroom.
Damn. That's a fucking public bathroom, nigga.
I was in the airport bathroom.
Damn. Well, I mean, I guess if you're not trying to, like.
Even when you look at Latin countries and stuff, they, man, they be topless half the time. Like, they mm-hmm. around, like
it's like Miami,
that's
bro.
True.
Dances and shit is just very sexual. It's like only America is really suppressing that.
Well, see, because I was saying, like, when we grew up, like, like, porno was like something like, oh, my God. Yeah, like, oh, porno, like, oh, sex? No, like, oh, like, and now it's, like, sex is everywhere. Like, just everywhere. And then, like, you can't even get your kids. I mean, you can protect them at, to some point, but that's just going to pop up anyway.
But I think it's also they were suppressing it and not teaching it well enough in school.
Mm-hmm.
Just, like, maybe we don't really talk about it as much or do the bare minimum, you know what I mean? Then it'll kind of just go away.
Yeah.
And you see, you have all this.
Yeah.
Yeah,
and I would say like our generation, you know, when we were growing up in high school and shit, we was part of the problem. I would say because
that nigga was
we were part of the problem, bro. I'm gonna just go ahead and say it because of course our parties was next level freak shit. You know, Pretty Ricky dancing, Chris Brown, like that type shit. Like we was the generation that started to send nudes. Type shit, you know, we started that shit. We was the first generation with camera phones. Yep. We invented send nudes type shit. So I just feel like
you ever sent a nude?
Of course, yeah, hell yeah. Nigga had a digital camera, but it was like
that shit was blurry as fuck. Nigga just
look all pixeled out and shit. Like,
said, where's your dick at? It's right there. Nigga, the black spot right there. Just fucking share.
A nigga dick made of blocks and shit. Like, just zoom in on it. Don't over trip.
Yeah, like what the fuck? Like, I remember watching porno, bro. I had this. Bro, like this fucking piece of shit phone, bro. Where like someone half of the screen was like pixelated and the other one wasn't.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, what? And then always like the girl's pussy or at or like titties was on one side. I'm like, I'm just watching dick. I'm like, fuck. Bro, I'm like, I don't want to. So then I just put it in my ear and just like imagine it. Cause
that
I was
sounds,
like, yeah, bro. But I never sent a nude.
Never?
Never.
Oh, shit.
Never sent
it. Yeah, probably. My shit in the dark web somewhere too.
Yours?
I don't ever show
you
my.
You sent nudes? Did long time ago?
Yeah.
I'm gonna send a nude to Lydia today. Fuck it. Mm. Take me taking the shit. Like, what's that?
Whole sex
thing. They can put on OnlyFans. They can make money off of it. Shit.
Yeah,
I'm trying to do OnlyFans.
I know. I'm trying to get that extra bread on the side.
Right on camera. Don't edit that out.
No, I mean, anybody that needs extra money, fuck it, bro.
Yeah.
But then I'm like, bro, like my video's gonna be like 2 seconds. Like nobody's really gonna click on that.
Nigga
bitch.
Going that fast, like, all right.
Drugs anyway.
Yeah, bro. You ever try those pills?
Yeah, the Blue Chew.
Yeah, I tried Blue Chew.
You haven't tried the Blue Chew, the honey packet. You haven't tried
nothing.
It?
You never tried nothing.
All I do is drink red wine. That shit.
Yeah.
Wine. I think I had you going crazy.
Yeah, I mean when you have fucking whiskey dick too, I go, I'm in that bitch forever.
Yes.
Like if Lydia knows Lydia knows I'm drinking, I'm like, nah, you ain't getting that.
Uh-huh.
Like, you like in that bitch forever. I'm like, nah, what the fuck? I try the Blue Chew.
You gotta know your butt in that is like, all right, if I'm taking too long, you can just do this and finish it. You feel me?
Yeah. You know what I like to do? Is like smoke and weed.
Uh-huh.
I mean, smoking weed and drink.
What the hell are you smoking? Nigga, sherm? I like to get wet. I like to get wet and start taking my clothes off. Nigga, start sweating and shit. Nigga.
Nah, like weed and drink, because I like that. Like, I don't win that bitch. And I'm like, I already know my brain. I'm like, oh, yep, I'm right here. I'm like, but if I just drink, like if I like get drunk and... My dumb ass is always horny, so, like, hey, you want some? No, because I was white. You're drunk. So what? It's gonna be fast. Yeah, okay. You say that other time.
Mm-mm.
I'm like, I'm in and out.
That's another thing about when you got in-house, like, it's gonna be quick.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. You got time to really just get in there and you always gotta be fast.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
That's like, I know, what is like the standard time for like,
in-house?
Yeah. What is like a standard time? Like 20 minutes.
That's max, probably.
Yeah. I would say.
Because it's not even like even role playing that bitch. It's like just, I was like, what, like my shit's not like you're not even wet. Just going there. I'm like, man, what's like there? It's going look at scratches and shit.
Mm.
But like a regular time is what?
I would say like in my household, we probably go like two rounds, so it'll last about 35 minutes.
Two rounds?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Hey, that's better than
about 35 minutes. You know, we'd take like a little intermission real quick. You
go
know,
get some sandwiches, some fucking.
You know what I'm saying?
Shit.
That's and yeah, that's counting foreplay and shit. So yeah, about 35
you break
minutes.
It down. How much time on foreplay?
I would say
it's
like,
kind of quick though.
You can't do foreplay for too long.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, penetration.
Like no oral type foreplay.
Mm-hmm.
No oral type foreplay. You know, by the time you jump in the thing, you know,
yeah,
you're ready to, you know what I'm
saying?
Yeah.
Do a yeah. No.
That's all I say. Like, shit, once I'm rock hard, that's it. Like, nigga, you don't got to do nothing else. Nigga, you either going to give me some or I'm about to just do my thing right now while you giving me some. So, you know
facts,
what I'm
facts. Now, for me, like, I'm 30 minutes.
30 minutes, yeah.
30 minutes, two rounds.
Damn,
and if I'm in a blue chew,
Oh yeah, I forgot to tell.
Yeah,
I forgot
first,
to tell the story when he gave me
first,
a blue chew.
At first it didn't. I'm like, this shit. So now I'm like, all right. But what happened? Like I took. Well, I got a pack of like five or something or ten. Mm. So I took it, but I had just eight. So I took it, and so it took longer. But the thing is, with blue chew, it doesn't like keep you not empty stomach, but like something light. So I took it. I had just like pasta and fucking. Steak and shit. So I'm like, all right, this is, mm-hmm. we don't have the daughter. Pop that bitch. I was like, yeah, it's my rock your world, girl.
Nope. Damn.
Two pumps and I was out. I was like, yeah, man.
That's just supposed to keep.
Yeah, well, so it didn't work. Like, but then I looked it up. And I was like, what the fuck? Why isn't it, like, am I sick or something? But the guy was like, oh yeah. Like I went on YouTube. You know, you can find anything on YouTube. So went on YouTube. He said, no, don't do it. Like if you're gonna do it, like. No, he said if you're gonna eat before, make sure like it's gonna be a long night, so like mm-hmm. it can hit you, like and but if it's gonna be boom boom, just have like a little sandwich.
Mm-hmm.
And it hit you later? Well, see the thing is, it or doesn't.
Once you already
so what happens is blue chew. I don't know if your experience. Yeah. It doesn't like it keeps you hard. Like when you're done, it goes down.
Yeah.
But when you're in it, shit, like it stays hard.
Yeah.
So. The first time I was like, oh, this didn't work. So I popped. The second time I popped two. I'm like, oh yeah. I was like,
yeah, nigga, I don't know how you did that. Nigga.
I was like, bro, like this shit, like it worked, but it didn't. Like it was just like whatever. Mm-hmm. So the third time I popped it, and that's when I had like a little bit of food, and I popped it, and I was like, oh shit, like I just kept going.
Mm.
Damn, it was already 30 minutes? Damn. All right.
Yeah, that went by quick.
All right, we're back. But yeah, so the third time I took it, that's when it actually worked. Like it was, I'm like, oh shit! Like I buzzed and I kept going. Uh-huh. So I have a homie at work. Before you get your story going,
right.
You know he's if you see this, bro, I'm sorry, I'm putting your shit on blast, but mm-hmm. it's funny. So my boy's fresh off. You know he's a newcomer. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Literally a newcomer. And so he was like, oh, you know, and I was like, how's your shit going, bro? How's the sex life? Oh, it's going good, bro. But you know, I try to keep going after I bust, but it feels weird.
Wow.
And I said, nigga, what? That's the best feeling, nigga.
Yeah.
The only thing I can't do is when I bust and then they keep.
Yeah.
I'm like, I got baby deer legs, nigga. My legs are like just like shaking and shit. Like I'm like, oh no, stop.
That's it.
I'm done. But you saying your blue chew story?
Oh yeah, my blue chew story. I think it was about a month after you gave me the pill, so I was just like, all right, fuck it, you know.
I'm over here slinging blue chews. If you want one, let me know.
He slid that shit to me real quick, popped it on date night, and it was successful, man. We had a pretty good night.
Did you tell her you popped it?
No.
Did she know like any?
I don't think she knew, but she knew that she didn't have to give me no top to get the night started. So.
Oh, so it worked like right away.
Yeah, it worked right away. So.
Like 30 minutes later or like?
Yeah, it was just close off, bam, boom, boom, boom. You know, we did our couple.
No, like when you popped it, it was like right away. Like
oh boom. No, it was at the dinner table actually. Nigga was at. I went to the bathroom, popped it real quick. I was like, all right, we got another 30 minutes before we leave the restaurant. So, you know, we went out. I think
did you chew it or you like fucking?
I chewed it.
Okay,
I chewed it because you told me nasty, it tastes like chalk, bro.
Yeah, I was like, ah, this shit is gross. I had to get water.
That shit, it was like chewing on a fucking chalk eraser. Yeah, I'm like,
blue chew, if you see this shit, make it a little like taste like strawberries, blueberries, whatever berries.
Yeah.
Just fucking do it, bro. Cause it's oh yeah, like
niggas
that.
Used to take those as kids. Yeah
those like
shit.
That. It tastes like that.
Yeah, I hate it though.
And it had a nasty aftertaste. Like, I don't know, my shit got stuck in back of my throat. I don't know if that shit happened to you. Yeah. I'm trying to get that shit out with water and shit, like shit wouldn't happen.
That shit turned into powder. That's why you like nigga trying to swallow. Like, damn, it's like having a Popeye's biscuit. Nigga start choking. Like, god damn, these are water, nigga.
For reals. But no, yeah. So Blue Chew, if you see this, sponsor us.
Yeah,
man.
Fuck it.
Also Manscaped. Also Manscaped, man.
Save I know.
Gave me a little mullet.
We're gonna hop into this next segment, man. Before we hop into it, man, I'm gonna ask Tim. There was a beef going on between Drake and Kendrick, obviously.
Oh, we already know this.
We talked about this on the last episode. Who do you think won? Who had the upper hand?
Well, I think Drake was fine in a losing battle regardless.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it was already a losing battle, but I feel like just once you get the culture involved in anything, like, because black people won't ride with black people at the time. Who they want to consider black at the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
They're going to ride with them regardless.
Mm-hmm.
So, but they both make bangers. Like, I still slap both their tracks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. Which one was your favorite one?
To me, Family Matters.
Yeah, I told you, bro. Matters, bro. That nigga.
Just from pure rapping standpoint, not even like, I'm just looking for the punchline, like just straight rapping, like
gas
that day. Yeah.
Yeah.
But Kendrick gassed Euphoria.
Yeah, Euphoria was hard as fuck.
Like Gusto, I already knew once you, that was a culture song.
Yeah, just the beat, just when the beat came up, I was like, oh.
Most people, they're deaf to the beat, they can care less. If it was just a straight beat and you put that instrumental, I promise you they would still dance.
Yeah.
Yep.
But he did the right thing because he wasn't the West Coast with it, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He knew the route to take. Yeah. People are already like, oh, Drake is this old Jewish dude, so.
He's Jewish?
Yeah.
Drake is Jewish?
Yeah, his mom's Jewish.
Oh,
yeah.
Fucking Drake.
Yeah, but, once you got the culture behind you, it was awesome at that point.
I was like, West Coast all the way, so. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Even though I like Drake. Like, you know, Drake is, like, I like his music, but I was like, to me, Drake is more like a party music. You feel me?
Yeah.
I don't see him as like a rapper, but not like a lyricist like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like Kendrick is different. Like Kendrick got lyrics, like where I'm like, oh fuck, like this nigga got lyrics.
And I also think like people was waiting for Drake's decline. They was waiting for him to fall off.
Yeah, I know. I mean, after this, you're gonna when they drop the album, like.
Oh yeah, we're gonna forget all about that shit.
You're gonna see the rise on that shit. Cause, like everybody's also hype about it.
Drake held his own against a lot of people. Now I wish he would have put his focus mainly on Kendrick. Because like, man, these other people, first of all, nobody's worried about them.
Yeah.
So I wish he would have put all his focus on. But then again, it's hard to just get even dirt on people.
And
then once these allegations just start flying on both sides, I'm like, all right.
Yeah, that shit was getting out of hand.
Who do you think that shot up Drake's security guard?
Well, everybody in Canada already talked about that shit. EXO and Drake and Drake's crew. They're beefing up there like they're little individuals.
Oh, they got like who beef?
Before that happened, they said somebody from a bodyguard from EXO's crew got shot.
Oh.
Yeah, so that was like kind of a retaliation, I guess.
Oh.
Yeah, so that has nothing to do with Kendrick.
Okay. Let me ask you guys, because this is going all over TikTok. What do you guys think about the Canadian accent?
The Canadian accent?
Yeah.
I've only,
what?
Well, one video I saw of that one girl talking.
Yeah, he's like, hey, fam.
What's up, fam?
Did you hear it?
Nah.
Bro.
I didn't know Canadians had an accent, though. What they?
But the majority of Canadians I ran across have, like, a French accent.
Oh.
Because they're, I guess,
French. They're right?
Yeah, they have, it's like a French-Canadian slang type thing. Mm-hmm. So they speak kind of like French.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It sounds crazy. Yeah. They Canadian, man.
They talk like
them niggas got free health care. I fuck with Canadians then. Shit.
Yeah, this nigga dumb.
Land of struggle.
Hey, and that's the other country that lets people in too, like crazy.
Canada?
Yeah, they just let them in just like us.
Yeah, they do.
They just come in, come on in.
It's a miniature United States.
Yeah.
Little brothers, basically.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's like fucking coffee bean in Starbucks. Here you go, bro.
I'm about to show that video of that girl talking. Or which one is
yeah.
Shoot, I don't know. That's
the bad. Toronto accent is quickly usurping the Baltimore accent for the.
Oh, no. Was that an ad?
Mm. Hold on.
I do. Online, her name is Plush.
Yeah, no. Right here.
And what I don't like is if the business is true that you left your mom's in the hood, somebody go smoke that you.
Ever been stumped by the Toronto accent while you're not?
That accent.
Hold on.
Yo, these guys are racist, fam, and I hate when niggas try to act hood, fam. It's not hood, brusky. When you try to act hood, fam, you're not hood, fam. Real spill. You know, like, stop moving bald when you're a good you, fam. You guys are a good you, see?
What are your thoughts on Toronto hoodmans?
What hey, the fuck?
Yeah,
it's
bro.
Like it's like a...
And what I don't like is if the business.
It has a lot of cultures integrated in that shit.
Yeah. Like fam. Like
fam, you get that shit from New York. Like.
Nah, isn't fam from New York, like the UK? Like I listen to a lot of music.
I know a lot of New Yorkers use fam.
Oh, yeah. Hey, fam. Like, but.
I've always seen New Yorkers use it. I don't know.
But that is true, though.
Because I listen to a lot of, like, UK music. Like Afrobeats.
Uh-huh.
And them niggas, they use a lot of fam in it.
Mm-hmm.
And the rap, too.
Get that from New York?
Well, I don't know. Probably. Yeah, you're right.
Mm-hmm.
Beginning of time, you know what I mean? So I don't know if they got that from New York.
Yeah, probably. Yeah. But yeah, the accent is. Shout out to all my Canadian friends.
It's weird.
The accent is up there on the terrible list with, like, Baltimore and Memphis.
Baltimore, that's
funny. Baltimore has an accent?
Yeah.
You never heard of Baltimore accent? Oh, my.
That's the funniest shit. It's so funny, bro. It's the way they pronounce their words, bro. It's just funny, bro.
I follow these guys that they do like that. These dance.
Terrible. Boston's is terrible.
Yeah, Boston.
Boston's terrible.
Baltimore accent.
I know Boston, man. Boston, there's a lot of racist people out there. There's a lot of racist people in Boston. Mm-hmm.
Start going south and towards the east, like,
yeah. I can't fuck with it, bro. I feel like I'm about to get lynched out there.
Yo, it is, Dommy. Hey, bro. Chill out with all that, bro. I ain't stupid, bro. I ain't dumb, bro. I'm educated, bro. What the fuck are you talking about? Like, what you want, bro?
Fuck is you geeking for, Dommy? She ain't even like what that big, bro.
That's a Baltimore.
I was about to say, bro. I don't know about.
Come on, Jiggle Langley.
Can you speak the Baltimorean accent? He's where? Manuk.
You ready? You sure you ready for that?
I'm ready.
Let me see your motherfucker real quick.
Oh, all right.
Y'all ready?
Yeah, we ready.
You feel me? I don't got the bit we ain't right now. So you feel me? Mm. You feel me? It's all about the bit we ain't gonna get we ain't. Smack your Manuk. You feel me? You ain't fucking stupid. Stupid. You feel me? You ain't no dummy for real. You feel me? You better get your shit around the fucking way for real. Mm. So we got 1, 2. You feel me and my man?
Yeah,
what the fuck?
That's a Baltimore accent, yeah.
What the fuck?
If you ever listen to YG Addy, aka ASAP Ant, if you ever listen to his music, man, he got that Baltimore accent. He's dope though.
I didn't even know Baltimore had an accent. Like I said the story before, but I went to me, Lydia, James, we were taking a road trip to Florida, and we stopped at this little ass town in Louisiana. And we went to go get a gumbo and shit, right? Mm. So we stop at this. So we walk in. I'm on the phone with my mom, with my cousin. And my cousin owed me $150, right? So he calls me and I was like, hey, I got the money. I said, all right, get 100 on my mom and keep 50 for you. And then he was like, the girl looked at me like, the cashier, right? And she was like, where you guys from? And I said, I'm from Cali. And she was like, your accent is so weird. Mm-hmm. I said, what? What do you mean? She's like, 100? And I'm like, yeah, what the fuck? And then she had a country accent, but I was like, man, I love country accents. So I was like, and she was white, too.
Yeah.
So I was like, damn.
That really turned him on.
I said, good luck, my wife was right here, really. Yeah. Remember, you know, little snow bunny I worked, I mean, at school that played me.
I don't know about that. What are you talking about?
At school? Nigga, you know. Fuck that bitch.
Yeah, I remember her.
Yeah, nah. But, yeah. Yeah, so, and then I saw a man. I looked at Lydia and I was like, damn, we have an accent. And she's like, I don't even know we had an accent. I was like, she goes, maybe you, because you like grew up in the hood. And I'm like, you grow down the street from me. So stop playing with me.
Neighborhoods, though, it really be like that. Like it'll be one block that's just one block over, it's completely different.
Yeah. Like, y'all speak proper, but they speak in slang and shit. Yeah, that is true.
Like, I remember when I first met Lydia, we were walking. She came to the house and I'm walking her back home. And I seen the police and I said, oh, there's the Wawos right there. Mm-hmm. And then she's like, the what? And I was like, the Wawos. And she was like, what the fuck is that? And I was like, the police. And she's like, why you call it a Wawo? I was like, I don't know.
That's another nickname.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was like, I don't know. Yeah. I was like, I don't know. The fucking boys, the pigs, the, you know, whoever. Yeah. The Ferrellis, the fucking. And she was like, wow, I can't believe you say that. And then, like, what other word I use? And she was like, oh, she's like, wow, I can't. I don't know what other word I use, but I used to, and she was like, what? Like, you don't make no sense.
It's a foreign language.
I said, man, whatever. Just because you grew up on the other side, like down the street from me, where we used to fight all the time.
I think California speaks the closest to like the actual.
Really?
English, yeah.
Out of this country.
What's your favorite accent?
I like French accent.
French.
And Spaniards? Fuck the Spaniards.
I like that.
Fuck them. They took over mine. All three of my countries.
Shit, all of Europe been colonized by the motherland, so I mean.
Oh, man. Yeah, that's true, nigga. We been took away from our shit, nigga.
What's your favorite accent?
I'm starting to get used to how my girl talks, because her Colombian accent, I always thought. Yeah, I always
like
thought
the Spanish accent, or the English?
Yeah, the Spanish accent.
Oh, okay.
I always thought it was same as Mexican Spanish, but their Spanish is just so much faster. But it's
but
Mexican Spanish is closer to Spaniard.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Like if you go to Spain, you will hear more of that type of. Because
they talk slower.
Mm-hmm.
You know what accent I like, and it sounds weird, but the Irish accent. I don't know why.
Really?
Yeah.
I like the English
Street
accent.
Yeah, the British accent too.
The British accent.
Yeah.
That's some sexy ass shit too.
The proper, like the motherfuckers say, you want a cup of tea? Type shit.
From a woman, though, nigga.
Not a nigga though. I like the which one?
Latin accents, just like.
Oh. Oh, yeah, Brazil,
man.
It's about a cabeza.
That's how
I just remember that because of jiu-jitsu. I'm like, what? What did you say? Not cabeza.
You should hear my girl talk to her mom, bro. That shit is the craziest shit.
Yeah.
Because it's so fucking fast, but it's so, like, when she say words, it's like, fuck.
Well, I remember your girl, when I was talking to her in Spanish, she kind of looked at me and she was like, what did you say? And I'm like, what?
Yeah.
She's like, you're talking a little bit too fast for me. I'm like,
yeah. Yeah, but she liked the way you talk, though.
Shit, Diablos. Who? Oh, yeah. See, like, I always tell people, like, the difference between Puerto Rican, Cuban. Cubans, they talk it, right? But they talk it like they want to. They're running for fucking, like, the next dictator. They're, like, fucking going out, like, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, man, all right, relax, nigga. Like, we just having a conversation. Like, when my mom be asking me shit, I'm like, mom, you just asked me for water. Like, you said all this other shit. Just say, give me water. Yeah.
Directly at you.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Man, I would, going to like another country, like what is like your preferred destination when you go on vacation?
Like, where would I want to go?
Yeah.
Well, at the top of my list, like, what are we speaking? Like, just
Just anywhere in general. Like, you would like Italy? Yeah. Mm. Just because, one, I love Italian food. Okay. And two, I'm big on Roman history. So. Yes. I would like to see, like, the hieroglyphs and shit like that. Yeah. No, it's like, seeing, like, the Roman church and, like, shit like that.
You want to go to the Colosseum and shit?
Mm-hmm.
I like the Rome. I like Italy, too, because I feel like...
Mm-hmm.
I like the mafia. That's what it is. Yeah, that's why I like. I want to go to Sicily just to go and be like, hey, where the fuck are real mafias at? But what about you?
I was just thinking about it. I like to go to Iceland.
Mm.
Yeah, yeah. I heard it's beautiful out there. It's clean air. It's like everybody's nice. They say, you know, Iceland. Everybody's nice. Yeah.
I want to go to Sicily. Switzerland. Yeah.
Switzerland. Mm-hmm.
I seen that pictures and Lydia always said because that's her place, and I'm like, damn. And I like the snow, so I'm like,
yeah,
that shit look nice. I'm like, that shit look nice. I could meet Santa Claus for reals.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And Lego, I think Lego was in Switzerland too. Yeah. Have you seen that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I you guys seen that show on Netflix? I think it's called like I forgot the name of it, but they talk about the toys, like how the toys came up about. Like, mm-hmm. So they have the Ninja Turtles, they got Hot Wheels, they got all this shit. So I was watching the Lego one. Mm. Sorry, I got flies in here because these motherfuckers. But you were going to say something.
Oh, yeah, before we jumped into that whole thing, I was going to say, like, the whole Diddy situation.
Oh, man.
Like, He issued an apology today, and the one thing he didn't mention was Cassie's name, obviously, and he was just apologizing about the video. But I just thought he apologized because he finally got caught, and I just wanted to get y'all outlook on his apology. What did y'all think about it?
It was trash.
Mm-hmm.
Could have kept it.
Mm.
Yeah.
He only did it probably because, one, his lawyer told him, two, people that he's probably partnered with.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No. Yeah, like
just a few days before the video came out, he was talking about, oh, they ain't got nothing on me, like I'm saying all this innocence.
True,
like,
yeah.
Video dropped, now he apologized. Like, you don't really care.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's just been involved in so much stuff. Like, this is surface level stuff that's coming out. Like, it gets way deeper.
Like, I was talking to Lydia. Like, I don't see it. Like, all the like, the sex shit. Like, I didn't see nothing new about it because, you know. It's Hollywood.
Mm-hmm.
That's just happening every day.
But also, I know there was a video or something out there. I forgot who was that was calling Diddy. Was it a Fed? Who was it that was calling Diddy?
Oh, Kanye.
Yeah, Kanye called him a Fed.
Yeah.
And I believe he is. Two, I think the only reason they released this video is because the Fed obviously released it.
Right.
Yeah. If he's a Fed,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're right.
Can't be charged.
Yeah,
he cooperated.
Yeah. But at that point, I was like, damn, like they hear, like, this niggas cannot be touched.
Yeah, he can't.
You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy.
That B status is very hard for you to fall.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
You can't trust any billionaire. I don't care what, like, Elon Musk tries to come out and put on this whole, the nice billionaire.
Yeah, I know.
Anybody that's a billionaire has done some shady things to get to that point.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. So,
and I feel like they're all involved with each other. Regardless if they have these little beefs here and there, they're all involved.
Yeah.
And you know what's the crazy part is that, after the incident happened, he had bribed the hotel owner for the videotapes. So he already knew what he was going through. So he thought ahead and was like, all right, let me buy him out and get the video from him. And dumbass didn't burn the tapes or destroy them. Like, you kept them in there for the fucking police to raid your house and find them. And now the video is out. Like, nigga, why would you keep that video of you beating up a girl?
Be a smart criminal.
Be a smart criminal. Then nobody in your camp tell you, nigga, you should burn them, bro. By the way, I don't know why you kept them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's, yeah.
Yeah.
He'd be like, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, that's right. Right. Keep that. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, his image is already fucked up. Yeah. Man. The black community, we done dropped his ass already because that was some brutal shit what he did to her.
For
he,
stuff like that, there shouldn't be statute of limitations. Like,
nah, you.
How can you watch that video and be like, well, time has passed, so we can't do it? Like,
yeah.
What kind of law is that?
They done got Bill Cosby raping bitches 50 years ago.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
They 60 years old. And that nigga's talking in about there. He touched me when I was 20. Yeah. What the fuck?
But you can't get Diddy for something that happened with like 6 years ago.
Yeah.
That's some crazy shit.
Fuck yeah. I mean, my boy Bill Cosby should be out and about right now.
He is out and about.
Is he?
He got out a minute ago.
No way. I thought that nigga was still locked up.
Nah, Bill Cosby been out.
Oh, shit.
He ducked off. He like, shit, I'm old. I'm going to live out my last 2 years.
Might as well.
Man, I thought he was still in there. And bitch, like, damn, my nigga Bill Cosby still locked up for some shit that he did 40 years ago.
Yeah.
Fuck that nigga. Even though I still love Step in the Name of Love.
I know that.
That's my shit.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. I remember I went to somebody's wedding, and then like that's like a song that we always play in the family.
Oh, huh? Yeah. That's every black wedding.
And it was a black wedding, too. So, like, I'm like, I said, hey, can you play Step in the Name of Love? And they were like, no, because he's a raper. I said, I don't give a fuck. Yeah, I don't give a fuck. Yeah. I was like, man, come on. And then, like, we just played on the phone. We're just fucking going.
You played that at your wedding.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, we did.
Uh-huh. I remember that shit.
Yeah, yeah. Because that's like, that's like a, every time we get it, like, when we, like, me, Lydia, like, and our family get together, we always play that song.
Yeah.
But
it's a good time.
Huh? Did you? I don't know. I don't remember. I was just
Step in the Name of Love. Like,
but shit. It's Bill Cosby thing. I think the hotel people need to be something is happening as well.
Yeah. They should get arrested, nigga. Mm-hmm. What was this at, though?
I think this was like a hotel in LA, and this. You could tell by how she did it, cause she caught that nigga in the shower, cause he came out in the towel.
Yeah,
she was like, "I'm about to get out with this nigga in the shower," and he came out in the towel. Was like, "Nah, fuck that."
When I was watching it, I was like, "Damn, I wish she would have took the stairs."
Yeah,
just take the stairs. It takes too long to wait on the elevator.
Mm-hmm.
Like, just take the stairs and get up. Run, don't walk. Run.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And they
get
was having
other people's where he can't even. If he's bold enough to do that in front of other people, and people don't.
Yeah,
I know. That's the weird thing. Nobody was present in that moment. Like,
well, that's
how being
hotel. Yeah. Nigga, you can fuck in the hallway. Nobody will come.
That's
nobody,
crazy.
Nobody will fuck you. Like,
let me try it, nigga. Fuck around and get caught.
Yeah, like, why? You're going to shoot the podcast. Though. I'm arrested, nigga. Why? I was fucking in the hallway.
Fuck that, bro. Hell no.
Nah, but that's crazy. Like, I don't know. I just. If you see someone hitting a girl, will you do something?
Yeah. I think that's just
instinct. I'm going to smack a nigga. I'm going to smack.
Be like, bro, like, chill. Like,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to smack the nigga at Home Depot. I'm going to smack them. I was barely in. Like, I was kind of, like, new to the. And I was in Garden. And me and my boy Juan were walking. And then there was this Indian couple. And the nigga smacked the shit out of her, bro. And I'm telling you, like, it was just smack. Yeah.
Damn.
So I'm like, so I walked up. I was like, yo. It's like, and then I was like, you guys need help? And the lady looked at me like, still kind of dazed, like, what the fuck? And she's like, yeah. And then he was like, no. Boom, smacked her again. I said, yo, what the fuck? And I pushed him. And I said, like, what's going on? And she was like, no. Like, I said, oh, like I took and I, my boy. I said, get her. And then, so my boy took her. And I was like, what the fuck's wrong with you, bro? Like, that's a female. And he's like, I don't know. He was saying, I was like, man, you a bitch. And he started getting close to me, and I was like, oh, I'm about to hit this nigga. And I'm looking around, and my manager hits the corner, and I'm like, oh. And he's like, what's going on? I was like, oh, he just hit her. So, and I'm like, the lady takes off, bro. Leaves that nigga there for like 8 hours. The nigga was walking around Home Depot for 8 hours. And then next thing you know, she picks him up.
Yeah.
But I feel like a lot of people in my mom said, a lot of those girls, like, they kind of, like, are used to it. So they come back.
Mm-hmm.
They come back, like, because my uncle was kind of like that, but the girl liked that. You know how some girls like to get beat before they have sex?
Mm-hmm.
My uncle had one of those. So one day I see my aunt had, well, she didn't.
Nah.
Like my uncle like had her like boosted up, and I was like, "What the fuck happened to her?" And he's like, "Bro, I'll tell you later." I said, "All right." So then like later he comes around the corner, he's like, "She likes to get beat." I said, "What do you mean?" Like, yeah, before we have sex, she wants me to smack around. I was like, "And you do that shit?" And he was like, "Yeah." I was like, "Oh, you a weirdo, bro?" And he was like, "Yeah, I don't know if I could do this anymore." Next thing you know, like, shout out to my uncle because he has 26 kids.
Damn. That nigga got a fucking football team, nigga.
He was a truck driver, so yeah. he was just fucking yeah, all over the state.
Did you ever see? It was going around on Twitter. It was a picture of like a kind of like an ATM machine or something, like the buttons, and it was at a truck stop, and it was like, if you know, you know. And it had like prices, like the first button was like $40, the second button was like $80, like
to get some
for like whatever prostitute. Yeah. Yeah. Oh shit!
And that $40 button was wore out.
That bitch is there.
I was like, "What the $40?
They
loving it." That
thing
was coming off. I'm like,
"Nah, fuck that.
I
want some head. I want."
I said, "These truck drivers."
Yeah, some shit, bro. That, like,
they done wore that number two out. Like,
yeah. But it's crazy because I tell my uncle, like, what, like, he's like, bro, I was just fucking, like, and then this was, like, in the 80s and 90s, so he was like, I'm just fucking, like, he has kids, like, are, like, literally, like, the same day, same, mm-hmm. like, nigga, like, it's crazy, mm. And, like, you know, shout out to my uncle, because he takes care of all of them, you know, gives them money, because that nigga, he has money, so okay. He's, like, he takes care of them. So shout out to that nigga because he said, no, fuck child support, yeah. If you need something, let me call me, and I got you. So, yeah, so shout out to my uncle, man, because he's about to be like, fuck you, motherfucker, we're putting my business out there. Oh, but hold on, because we have to cut and come back.
Yeah, I'm about to get in. I got to get into this with you. Fuck.
Yeah.
I forgot his name, but they drafted him early. I thought y'all was going to get him.
It was out of Drake Mayer. The only people we worked out was Drake Mayer, Jaden Daniels.
Damn. Yeah, that was some shit. That was a good draft class, though.
I like our receivers we got.
Who's your head coach?
Gerard Mayo.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. That's the first time in a long time.
He played for the Patriots. He's a linebacker.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, won the Super Bowls with us. Bill Belichick on. We got a black head coach, which is crazy.
Yeah.
On the Patriots, we got a black head coach.
That's crazy. How long was Bill Belichick with the Patriots?
Oh, man.
Damn.
Yeah, he was over 20 years. Yeah. Damn.
He was one of the coaches that were traded.
Oh, you can?
Yeah, that's part of like trade for like draft picks and stuff.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah, he was originally the Jets for one day, and then he got traded, fired, or something. It was like traded. So I forgot the whole situation was, but he ended up getting traded to the Patriots.
I didn't even know that.
Yeah. So, but I mean, before we cut the cameras, I just asked our guest Tim about his draft class, man.
Trash. Let's go, Fizz, baby.
Patriots haters.
So, the Patriots did draft Drake May. He's nice, man. He has an arm, man. He can throw it. He can throw any pass that I didn't see on the move, in a pocket, man.
North Carolina.
Yeah, North Carolina. Are you confident with that draft pick? Yeah, you think he gonna like? Of course, he's gonna start. But do you think he gonna come out to?
I think mainly because they put the right pieces around that will complement him well.
You think he's gonna start?
No.
He won't start.
No, because unless Jacoby Brissett. Yeah. Signed Jacoby Brissett.
Brissett was with us. Right.
With the Dolphins. I don't know.
He's black.
Colts. Yeah.
He was with the Colts. Yeah.
No, he Brissett was with us.
He was originally with us when it was Brady.
Yeah. Yeah, and then he went to the Dolphins for a little bit.
Did he?
Yeah.
I know he went to the Colts. I don't remember him on the Dolphins.
Yeah, he was going for... Yeah. Let me see. I'm talking about the right one.
Because I remember he was on the Colts, and then who got hurt? Somebody got hurt, and he took over for him for a little bit.
Oh, I think so. He went to like two or three other teams.
Yeah, and then he made his way back to us because we obviously needed a veteran quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
So he's going to coach him. I think if he does start, then hey, I'll take Drake May starting. I ain't mad at
it. Yeah.
You're a high pick.
Yeah.
Especially when you surround him by great players.
Mm-hmm.
Just throw him in there and let Brissett mentor him throughout the season. But if not, then he can sit for 1 year and learn.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know if it's me putting high expectations on him or what, but I want him to come in and do what CJ Stroud was doing with the team.
Oh, man. Shout out CJ Stroud.
That doesn't happen with every rookie. So
yeah.
I don't want to put those expectations on him, but I'm like, man, we've been trash the last few years since Brady left.
I know. That nigga Mac Jones, man, he tried, but, you know.
It was terrible.
Mm-hmm.
But we had a trash receiving core and couldn't nobody separate. Like,
mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true.
So it's just our offense is terrible, or was terrible. We should be good, though.
Now, I think as far as this draft class is, it's probably the best since we've seen.
Yeah, we had him in the Dolphins.
Did y'all?
Yeah.
Shit, damn. He did go to a couple teams, though. Yeah. I ain't gonna lie. But I think this was the best draft class as far as quarterbacks. Oh yeah.
What was that? That was with Joe Burrow and them, right? I think.
Trevor Lawrence.
Herbert.
Yeah, last 2001.
Joe Burrow was in there.
We had him in 2001.
Oh, I had him recently.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because I remember when Tua got hurt, he came in.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think he got hurt. Yeah. He got hurt or something happened to him. So then some other nigga came in. Mike something. Mm.
No,
I think so.
I think Spencer Rattler might be our savior after Derek Carr. We giving Derek Carr 1 year to prove himself. If we don't, I think Spencer Rattler will take over.
Honestly,
year.
I think we would have went further. Cheers, guys. We have a rule that every time every time I fuck up on a word, I take a sip. Nah, probably not, because I'm going to be drinking, so. But I think so. I think Tua is going to. We had a lot. Like, last year, everybody was hurt. We got hurt at the last. We beat you guys, so it doesn't matter.
You wanted to rub that in.
I fucking hate about every time, bro. Every time we
nigga,
put.
This nigga Tim did had about a 10-year run.
I fucking hated him, winning. Bro. I was like, man, I fucking hate Tim. Every Monday we come to school, I'm like, I see this nigga, I'm like, fuck you, bro. Yeah, like, I don't want to hear it.
That's why I'm like, the trash years, I'm not really, like, tripping off of.
Uh-huh.
We had to go through a rebuild.
Yeah.
It's hard to feel what Tom Brady was doing.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't even know Tom Brady was, like, number one something. 199.
Oh, yeah, man. He got
But that shit is
low.
Crazy. Because I was watching The Roast, and I said, I'm like, god damn, like, this nigga, like, came through. Like,
yeah.
I didn't even know he was from California.
Yeah.
He's from the Bay.
Yeah, he is from the Bay.
Man. Nah, that was like talking when he was there, like, oh, he might come to Miami. I was like, no, we don't want him. Take him.
Yeah.
Nah,
y'all would have took Tom Brady.
They said no.
Yeah, because they're idiots.
I mean,
hey,
yeah.
Watch your mouth.
He said no. The Niners said no. I guarantee you both Super Bowls, the Niners lost to the Chiefs.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck the Niners.
Yeah.
Probably both, honestly.
Yeah,
I think he should have went to the Niners.
That Purdy missed that he should have hit that Brady would have sure made.
Mm-hmm.
In both Super Bowls, he missed big throws.
I think he should have went to the Niners for sure. That would be some shit.
Or Jimmy G missed in the first one.
Fuck Jimmy G.
Purdy was not even starting, or he was hurt or some shit. I forgot what the other situation was. But Jimmy G missed some throws.
Where's Jimmy Dean at now?
The Raiders being trash.
But he's not starting with the Raiders, is he?
Yeah, he was starting.
Didn't they just got a quarterback too?
He might take Jimmy.
Mm-hmm.
Jimmy went out there and started.
Yes, mamas.
She know how to open doors now.
How you doing? Oh,
yeah,
she said, never mind. She said, there's niggas in there.
Oh, damn.
There's niggas in there. Let me know.
Close the door back, start calling you again.
Oh, what, mamas? Sorry, my daughter's out there. What? What? Huh? Okay, good. Save me some. You want to place that bet again?
Oh, hell nah, bro. I'm a Saints fan through and through. nah, bro, we finally got
that's what I'm saying, bro. Like,
you want to do the bet again?
Hell no, hell.
Why not though?
Yeah, hell no, hell no. I can't.
It's just a bottle.
What was the bet?
Who have a better record
at the end of the season? Yeah, I know, but it's do it again.
Hell no, shit, man. They let me down last year, man.
Nah, Aaron Rodgers. Nah, he's not doing shit.
First of all, the Jets defense is crazy.
Yeah, they defense nice.
The only reason they even were looking somewhat shaky last year, like through certain games, was because their offense kept them on the field because their offense was trash with freaking what's his name?
Oh, Zach Wilson. Zach Wilson.
Mm-hmm. Who you think is who do you think this year is gonna be a good team?
Oh,
besides like the obvious.
Who? Fuck Pose. I don't know why you're talking about Pose.
That nigga Pose, man.
The Chiefs are going to be good. Yeah. The offense will be good. The Bills are going to fall off a little without Stephon Diggs. And Josh Allen,
they lost a lot of people, though.
Josh Allen's a turnover machine. I'm just like...
Mm-hmm.
See, I feel like the problem with Josh Allen is, like, if it doesn't go his way, he just starts throwing his fits, or he just starts fucking up.
I feel like he just feels like he doesn't do too much.
Mm-hmm.
What about the Texans? Plays, what do you guys think about the Texans?
I think they're honestly going to take a step up.
Yeah.
Yeah, because they got them. They got a receiver or somebody.
They got Diggs.
Mm-hmm. They signed. I thought that Diggs went to the Cowboys.
He's on the Texans.
No, I mean, Texas, I guess. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, they did.
Who's going to be trash?
Let's see. Vikings will be trash.
Vikings definitely going to be trash. I mean, just
who?
The Falcons. And I hope they trash because they in our division. First of all, I hope they're gonna be trash. We hate the Falcons.
Got a trash division, so they might actually be somewhat.
Yeah, we got a trash division. I ain't gonna lie. We got our quarterback in our division is Baker Mayfield, Kirk Cousins, Derek Carr, and your boy out of Alabama. Who's your boy out of Alabama? That's on the Panthers. Bryce Young. Bryce Young. That's our quarterback. That's our quarterback tree in the South. NFC South.
Falcons, I'll take it back. Falcons will be middle of the pack. I think they'll be middle of the pack. Not great, not like really good, but they'll be
above bad. They'll probably go like 9-8 or some shit.
I think the Chargers are gonna be terrible.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
The receiver, like,
they lost, what's his name?
Okay, my sleeper team though is the Commanders. Yeah, that's my sleeper team because they was decent without a quarterback last year.
Who the guy now?
Jaden Daniels.
Oh.
They were decent without a quarterback last year, and that was surprising coming from like a team that was didn't have a good wide receiving core, didn't have a good O line, but they still.
What was their name before?
The Redskins.
You know, yeah, they're trying to change it because the actually what they're saying that the logo was actually a chief, like somebody's. No, it wasn't racist.
They said it was racist.
Yeah, but the guy, the
people.
Yeah, the natives, but they wanted because the guy that they have on the helmet was like some one big chief. So they're like, we want that back because you're kind of like.
You're a representative.
Yeah.
It was woke culture, you know, when the council culture wave first hit. Yeah. That's when they were like, oh, you need to get this, calling them Redskins.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, man, this team has been around since the day.
Yeah, what's the oldest team?
You got the Packers and
the Bears.
Who?
The Jets? Packers for sure. Packers is like the first damn team, one of the first. Lions.
And I know the Bears is one of them.
Packers, Lions. I think the NFC North.
I know. What do y'all think of Caleb Williams? Him being the first overall draft pick. He gonna show out?
Yeah.
He got Keenan Allen to throw too.
Oh, yeah, he does.
DJ Moore. Ooh. Damn.
Last year. Like, and then you got Romo Dulles, who was a top receiver in the draft. Like, yeah. They surrounded him with crazy.
Dang, that shit's so gross.
The Bears
bro.
Wasn't crazy. Like, they weren't terrible last year.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Really, that's true.
They have a quarterback. And they're about to get a new stadium.
Oh, yeah, they are.
Indoor stadium.
So, did you guys know that? I mean, we're talking about football, but the A's are moving to Vegas?
Yeah, I heard about that.
That shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, that shit's nice. Man. Vegas. Oh yeah,
yeah,
definitely.
Man, mm-hmm. I like the A's.
Yeah, you like.
If I wasn't a Boston fan, I probably would have been an A's fan. I don't care. I just like the Bay.
Yeah, I was like, hey, the Angels. Well, you know, that leaves the Dodgers. You know what I'm saying? You know.
Fuck the Dodgers, bro.
That's we got. Why they need a salary cap on baseball.
Y'all I know that nigga Ohtani. All-star team.
Man. Yeah,
my nigga Mookie Betts. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Well, you guys,
go ahead, bring another championship home, man.
They're not gonna get it, bro. I'm telling you, if you guys didn't fucking win it last year.
That don't mean nothing.
If you guys don't win it with Ohtani, bro, you guys are trash.
Oh well, obviously he signed a 7-year deal, so within that 7-year period, huh?
His first year is gonna be his best year with you.
Yeah.
Nah,
he's not pitching this year.
He's not.
No, he's not pitching this year.
Coming off of Tommy John surgery.
Yeah, he's not pitching this year.
So, and that's why this is gonna be his best year because he can solely focus on
hitting. Yep.
So not the bat and pitch, and then but when he starts pitching, his numbers not gonna drop crazy because obviously he was still killing it on the Angels, but it's not.
Shit, I know he's selling out tickets. That's for sure.
Yeah.
Fuck. I was trying to go to a game. I mean, the cheapest tickets were like $70.
That's not
but
bad. We should go.
Yeah. But that's all the way in the nosebleeds.
Okay, nigga.
Yeah, look, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true.
You got a whole All-Star
but
team
shit,
in there.
When it wasn't Ohtani, you... nigga, $40.
$30. If it's going to be cheaper, just go to when they, the freeway series when they're in Anaheim. It's going to drop the tickets.
Yeah. Yeah, fuck it. I just go to Anaheim Stadium. Fuck it.
For real. I was supposed to go to him. when the
see Trout when he come back if he's back by then.
Mm. Trout's hurt.
He hurt, man. That boy hurt every year.
Every year.
What the fuck is wrong with him?
I think it was his knee. Somewhere.
He old. You need to stop.
But I'm like, man, you really like to go, bro. So
like, so the nigga that used to live down here in this apartment, he got signed to the Blue Rays.
Damn.
I mean, Blue Rays, the Blue Jays.
Did he like
on the minor league team?
Yeah.
So I'm like, well, when I was like, man, shit. I know that nigga. I was like, and then I seen the mom. I was like, oh shit, that's the nigga
that's
that used
crazy.
To live right here. And I always used to see him play. I played with him like a couple times, like catch. But I was like, man, this fool's. But then when they moved out, bro, I'm like, okay.
That's crazy.
Because the IE right now has a good amount of like players in professional sports.
Hell yeah.
Yes.
Like the nigga, what's his name from the Texans. He's from Rancho or some shit like that. Yeah.
What, CJ Stroud?
Yeah, he's from like I think he's Redlands. I think he's from Redlands.
Damn.
Yeah, and then that nigga, the running back for the Lions, is from Redlands too.
Damn. Yeah, that's crazy. Yeah, that's a lot of talent coming out of here.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
That's good. We bred.
Hey, what happened to?
We got Kawhi.
Yeah.
Oh, Kawhi. Yeah.
Yeah. Fuck, man. That nigga keep getting hurt, man. Fuck.
Hey, what happened to the nigga that was playing for the quarterback for USC? Is he?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Reggie Miller.
The quarterback for USC.
USC.
That's Caleb Williams. Yeah.
Where do you go?
Bears.
The Bears? Oh.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's nice, man.
He's nice, yeah. He kind of reminds me of Mahomes, so.
Yeah.
He kind of reminds me of Mahomes.
Nah, they compare Spencer Rattler to Mahomes, you know what I'm saying?
Nah, you better knock it off, bro. You want to make the bet?
Y'all remember?
You want to make the bet?
But do y'all remember when he had his own TV show in high school? Yeah.
Who?
And when he was in high school, because he was number one in the state. In high school, he had his own TV show.
What the fuck?
Yeah, if you look on YouTube, Spencer Rattler had his own TV show.
He still ain't doing shit.
I know, but it's because he got hurt, and then he went to, I forgot which school he went to before South Carolina, but he had got into some shit with that school, and then he transferred to South Carolina, and then he made a career of himself, and then he dropped shit to the 5th round of the draft, and we picked him. And, you know, he got a big upside, man. I like him. I hope Derek Carr fuck up and he eventually takes over. Because
damn,
I like to see him and Chris Olave, you know, kind of build that connection on the field, man. That would be dope.
Mm.
Are you guys gonna see the
Slant Boy? Oh no, Mike Thomas, he out of here, man. Yeah, we already released him, man. Shit. Yeah. He a free agent. Nobody picked him up. I wonder why.
I'm trash.
Most people are looking for a deep threat target.
Yeah. But shit, Mike Thomas got hands though. He catch everything that's thrown to him. He got hands. So anybody who pick him up, they definitely gonna upgrade.
Did you end up going to the game when they were out here?
Nah.
I think I'm gonna go to the Dolphin game.
Yeah.
We play the Rams.
Every five, yeah, New England. They'll never play nobody out here, huh?
I think the last time was the year after Brady left. I think it was the year after Brady left, or the year his last year.
Uh huh.
The Rams Chargers back to back. That's so far.
I'm about to say I don't never see him play the Rams or the Chargers or nothing like that's just crazy.
San Francisco in the Bay this year. I might try to go to that one.
Mm. Oh yeah, AD he a Saints fan?
Yeah, he a Saints fan.
But how long has he been a Saints fan?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. I was a fan when Drew Brees came, but I didn't really watch them like I do like after Reggie Bush came, because Reggie Bush, he brought that excitement, obviously being one of the top running backs in that draft class. But yeah, I would have to say. Yeah.
Reggie Bush, he's the best college player ever.
Yeah, he was.
Yeah. But
how did you like? How did you become a Patriots fan?
It was the first Super Bowl I watched with my dad in '97.
Oh, okay.
Mm. Yeah, so that memory stuck. We lost, obviously. And then on top of me, just always wanted to be in the military, which is probably some corny shit, but
it all connects.
It's just all connecting. I'm like, I'm a Patriot.
Oh, okay.
I've been watching them ever since.
So I went to Florida. To be real with you, I was a Niner. Like I was like when I was getting into football, I was a Niner fan. I remember going to the let me just take a sip right now because I'm like we went to the Salvation Army. Take another sip. And I found like a bomber jacket, 49er bomber jacket. And I told my mom, can you buy this for me? She said, yeah, it was like $10. And I was rocking that shit. So then I went to Florida, my first year, 2000, not my first year, but my first game, like an actual football game.
Mm-hmm.
It was like 2001 or 2002. And I went with my uncle. I think they were playing the Panthers or some shit like that. I don't know what, or the Jaguars, I don't know. But they won that game. And my uncle bought me a jersey, a Dan Marino jersey. He's like, oh, you're a Dolphin fan now. And I'm like, oh, okay. So then for then on, I'm like, oh, yeah, yup. I'm like, hell yeah. Do I know what happened to that jersey? I don't know what happened to that jersey. Mm. My mom probably threw that bitch away. Like, she always throws my clothes away. She throw that bitch away. And I'm like, so I couldn't find it. So then I said, mom, I didn't have a jersey.
Uh-huh.
So I called my dad. I was like, I need a jersey. And jersey, he's all 49ers. Like, nah. What? And I was like,
Dolphin jersey.
He's like, oh. And he was like, oh, you were with Uncle Jimmy? And I was like, yep. So then he's like, all right. So he bought me a jersey that didn't fit me. That shit was all the way to the floor, bro. And I put that shit on the game day. I put that shit on, but I could never find the game.
Was it a Ricky Williams jersey?
Yes. It was Ricky Williams. Yeah, I had a. Uh-huh. Then after that, I went to where did I go? I went to the Swami.
Ricky Williams was balling.
I went to the Swami and I called Adrian. Well, I called Rosa. Uh-huh. I said, is Adrian with you? She's like, yeah. So I said, hey, you want a jersey? I don't know if Adrian remembers this.
Uh-huh.
And he's like, why? And I said, oh, there's a Ricky Williams jersey right here. There's two of them. You want one? And he's like, yeah. Nigga, when I looked at the prize, I said, never mind. I don't know if Adrian remembers that. But I got that jersey. Then I had that jersey for the longest. I met Lydia.
Yeah, man.
Nigga, I met Lydia, right? And then we still have those jerseys. Can't believe it. Like, nigga, put them on right now. Nigga.
Yeah, nigga,
fucking
can't
sausage.
Fit them.
Yeah, and I said, oh, yeah. I told Lydia, I was like, oh, you gonna be a Dolphin fan now? You can't, like, you know, like, that's it. No, dog, you can't go back out. So we bought two jerseys, and then after that,
you know, my dad bought me another jersey, and that was when what's his name? Brandon Marshall was on the Dolphins, and that's when my dad got me that one for my birthday.
Yeah.
And then I didn't have one for the longest time. Liddy bought me one. And then now I got the connects with Post. If you want your jerseys,
I know. I'm going to holla at Post.
And Swaggy Poo.
Yeah, I know. I'm going to holla at Post.
It's crazy because I had just got a Christian Gonzalez jersey. Our rookie corner we had last year. A stud. Mm-hmm. He got hurt. He was somewhere with his shoulder. But he was locking shit. I got his jersey. He was number 6. Tell me why this fool changed his number. I had just got him, too.
Yeah.
And, like, literally the next week, I seen them announce that he changed his number to 0.
I saw that shit, man. A lot of motherfuckers have changed their jersey this year, too.
Yeah?
Yeah. Sure. So it's just like...
The part is, I got it from Post, so I can't even be like Fanatics or something. Like, let me do a jersey swap or something.
Like, nah,
Post. The fuck? You better be freaking... Man, let me get...
Hey, Post, I need a jersey.
Yeah.
Give me number 0,
Post,
nigga.
I need a jersey.
Yeah. I need to get Lydia a shirt, and then I need to get my daughter a jersey, too. Hmm. My daughter's more a fan than Lydia because every time I put the shirt on, she goes, "Go Fins." I was like, "That's right, baby. That's right. That's right, baby. Yep. You a fan, baby." Lydia just like, I'm like, "Hey, like Sunday comes around, I got a little routine. Like, I don't know if you guys got a what is it called?
I like mine out like it's the first day of school.
Yeah.
I like my jersey on the bed.
All right.
Okay.
Game, like a couple minutes before game time, I throw that thing off.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And if we're losing at halftime, I take it off. No, I do that though because I feel like I'm cursed.
I'll take it off.
Especially if it's like, because I always buy home jerseys.
Oh, okay.
So if it's like a away game, then I feel like I curse them because I'm wearing a home jersey. I take it off and we usually come back second half.
Oh, shit.
So like, you have, what is that called?
Yeah, it's like a pregame ritual.
Yeah, ritual. I said ritual. Shit.
I do. I have a pregame ritual. If the Saints are home, I'll stay home. I won't go nowhere. If my homies come out, hey, let's watch the game at Buffalo Wild Wings. Nah, nigga, we doing good. I gotta stay home, bro. Like, let me watch the game, then I'll come home and I'll go out and we'll watch the next game. But if they're away, I'll usually go out and like just like watch the game from like wherever we go out to eat or somewhere. But like that's like my primary thing. I'll stay home if we're at home. So because I want to watch that game. In fucking solitary. I don't want no distractions. I don't want niggas talking and niggas booing and I don't like none of that shit. So
because I be watching the games and I'll have my Apple Watch on, you know how it reads your heart rate or whatever. And my thing, man, it brings me close to my shit. It'd be like your heart rate is over.
Call 911. Call 911.
Like damn.
I'll be on the edge. My shit's the same thing like with Tim. I let my shit out. You know, the day before I put it on the dog cage. We got the dog cage in the room.
Mm.
Put it right there. Get my socks put on top of it. Nah, bro, stop playing.
Hey, Dolphins, fuck them niggas.
And Milo probably would do it because I think it's a hater.
Yeah.
I put my socks on her, and then the next day I get up, make breakfast. If we play in the morning, I'm like up at like fucking 9. And Lily's like, man, I can't stand you because you start screaming like.
Mm-hmm.
And then right before the game starts, I put the jersey on, the socks on. And I have to have the socks on because if I don't have the socks on, they lose all the fucking time.
Yeah, it's like, ugh.
You was living in our shadow for how many years?
The niggas couldn't get past the Patriots for about 20-something years.
Yeah, nigga. Bro.
Nigga had them socks with holes in them.
The guy was gripping the ground, nigga.
That's funny, because the fucking Patriots had that shit locked down for 20 years, bro. That's the funny part.
You guys went right when Brady blew his knee out. That was the year. Oh. You guys went
that
year, right?
What year?
I think it was 2011.
Fucking
2. Yeah.
2010, 2011 when he blew his knee out. I think that was the only time during Brady's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They won the division.
I mean, we beat you guys like maybe like two times. Like two times. Like we, yeah. We'll beat you like 2 times and I feel like it was like our Super Bowl and shit.
Yeah.
Like, fuck yeah!
Yeah, I would hate to be in a division with Tom Brady, man. Fuck.
Bro, I hated playing with like, every year. Fuck. When I see, we playing, I don't even want to watch this game. I don't even look at my phone.
People
like,
was always like, oh, it's because he was in an easy division. But Brady had a better record outside of the division than he did in the division.
Yeah.
I hated playing with Brady because he would do like some miracle shit. Like, they'd be down fucking 30 points and that motherfucker would come up.
He never lost his cool. He was always poised.
like, some shit.
As long as there's time, he's like, I got this. Like, I know what to do. I'm always poised.
Yeah.
Like, smart play. Like, I don't have to just keep chucking it down the field. Like,
he would do some shit.
Like, oh, we need Brady. Brady can't do this. Like, what? Do you guys even? Anybody that used to be like, Brady can't throw it down the field. I'm like, you guys don't watch Brady. Brady used
yeah.
to slaying that motherfucker.
Hell yeah.
Like, he only chucked it, like, checked it down when
he needed
nothing. Nobody was open. Like, why force it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Make the smart play, get a first down, or get like 5-6 yards, make it a short.
Mm-hmm.
Short, you don't need that much to gain, and then keep it moving. Like, why make the dumb play? And then, you know, you're third and long.
Mm-hmm.
Like, let me ask you this. What do you guys think about Odell going to the Dolphins?
Right about now, I think he's just on a. I just want
to. Yeah, you want another ring.
Ride the wave of something. I don't know. Like,
I think it's a good pickup for y'all, man. He bring a little bit more veteran leadership to the wide receiver core. Obviously, y'all got Waddle and Tyreek Hill, which is the fastest motherfuckers on the fucking field. So, you know, to have Odell, you know, I think he's going to play outside. I don't know if he's going to play the slot.
He should play the slot.
You think he should play the slot?
Yeah.
I think Tyreek Hill going to play the slot.
I think.
I mean, you can do that, but I think if you put Odell in the slot, then that gives you an underneath guy that, you feel me, that's going to take focus. Like, okay, now the top ain't over, the top ain't open. Boom, Odell in the slot. You feel
mm-hmm. Yeah.
And because if you keep Tyreek Hill outside, then that's a faster guy that can get open down the field. And yeah. The big plays, because Odell ain't going to get it open as fast. He can get separation, you feel me, because his footwork is crazy.
Mm-hmm.
But I think the slot would be better for him.
Yeah.
I think, yeah. Especially when you have the two fastest guys in the league.
Yeah.
You got to have them on the outside.
Oh, shit. Hold on. Mm-hmm. One more episode, one more season. All right. We're back. So Tim took off. But it was nice having him here.
Yeah, thanks for throwing out topics, man. Yeah. That was dope.
Like it, you know. Sometimes if you guys want to come in and just sit in the background and
give us a
just talk to us, but not being on the camera. You guys can always do that.
No, I think this last segment I'm gonna end it with
I got another one too.
Mm-hmm.
But go ahead.
There was a I was recently on Threads.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if, you know, people got Threads and shit, but I was, you know, scrolling down that timeline.
Mm-hmm.
And they were talking about Elon Musk doing the Neuralink.
The what?
The Neuralink.
What is that?
It's a chip that you're gonna, that he's planning to place into people's brains. Yes. It's some weirdo shit. I mean, it's kind of like having a fucking, like the internet in your head. You can pull up shit out of the vision of your eyes, you think it, you can pull it up, you know, click on it, look at a video, and it's all projected through your eyes and shit like that. Or you can use it as a payment process. If you're buying something, you can use it, your hand, and just scan your hand, but there's a chip in your head.
Mm-mm.
And they're already calling on participants to, you know, test it out and put it in their head and kind of, you know, introduce it to the world. So we'd be more open to it. So they started that process already. They already have somebody that did it. And I think it should be a safety hazard, kind of. Because they can take over your fucking brain, bro. They can take over your body functions. They can take over your thought process. You know, they can take over your thoughts, what you're thinking at this moment, like, I'm about to go rob somebody. Oh, shut this nigga down. You know, like that type shit. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, that sounds smart. Like when you think about, I'm going to shoot these people up.
Yeah.
Shut them down. But as in, I'm going to go in like religion. In religion form, religion talk right now.
Uh-huh.
But that's the
you ever heard of that?
Yeah, well, I heard about it. That's a beast market, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I don't like it. But if it happens, I guess it happens, you know. Like, but I don't think it's for everybody.
Yeah,
I think this is gonna be for like people that got money.
True. Yeah, because I know it's a whole procedure you have to go through because it's implanted in your brain, so it's a probably surgery you got to go through. For them to install it and
that's,
shit.
To me, is. Oh, man, guys.
to me, it's crazy because how does it work? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How does that work? Like when you, like how you say, like it pops up and like go now, like
yeah.
But yeah, it's crazy. I don't know. I don't. What do you think about it?
I definitely think it's like a futuristic thing to think about, to have out there, and I would say to help like the normal person, because I was reading about it. It also helps with depression. It also helps with
suicide. How?
I don't know. Technology. However, Elon Musk like, got it designed.
It takes over your brain.
Yeah. So they said it helps with depression. It'll make you think happy thoughts. It helps with anxiety when you're kind of pressured. Mm. You know, it also helps with the nervous system. You know, if you feel like your anxiety is taking over, it helps you calm down. I was just reading about it.
So they already have it on somebody?
Yeah. They're taking participants now. I'm pretty sure those are rich ass participants
who are gonna pay. Hell no, nigga.
Yeah.
Cause they have to pay you.
Yeah, they gotta pay you.
They have to pay. So like say if I'm doing a like, oh Mark, I came up with the fucking thing that makes your make you taller.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pay you for each leg. I'm gonna pay you $300,000 for each leg.
Right.
Right. Cause I'm gonna fucking destroy your body and make it longer or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So they have to pay you for that. Cause like my mom, she's getting paid to get surgery on her legs.
Okay.
Cause they're trying this new thing for your bunions.
Okay.
My mom got bunions. So, so they're trying these new things. So my mom's getting a surgery, I think like next month or something. Mm-hmm. But they're paying, I forgot how much money it is. She said that they're paying her for each leg.
Mm-hmm.
But when they're training something new, they have to pay you. Mm. So they have, like, they getting niggas like us that need money.
Right.
I'm pretty sure, like, they paying good money because that's, like... Yeah.
That's Elon Musk. Yeah, richest man in the world.
So, like, mm-hmm. you know, like, yeah. I'm pretty sure, like, they sorry, guys. I just woke up really early this morning. So, and then the drink, too. So, And then I watched my girl's car and my car, so I'm a little tired.
Oh shit.
by the way, if you want your old car wash, hit the AB's detail car. I'm just playing.
Yeah, you're doing all that.
I don't think they're getting niggas rich. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? Because they already got like they're getting the niggas that need money.
Yeah.
Cause that's the niggas that be like, oh shit, well, he's paying $20,000 to get this shit done. I need the money right now. Boom.
Yeah, that's true.
Like right now, I need that $20,000 because he might hit me up and I'm like, "Fuck yeah, let's do it."
go ahead and put it in my brain.
Yeah, man. put it in that shit. If it's gonna make me better in my podcast, let's do it.
Yeah, because it's supposed to I would say kind of help body functions. Like if your back is fucked up, it can help you sleep better. If you sleep different or you know, you didn't fucked up your back. It's supposed to help you with that type shit. It's supposed to be groundbreaking.
It's crazy because if you look at it, it's kind of making like a robot.
Yeah, that's crazy. The scary part.
And
yeah.
it's like what's that song? iRobot.
Uh huh.
It's kind of like that, bro.
Yeah.
I want to watch that movie again.
Good movie.
Good ass movie.
Yeah.
But I do have a talk another one. If you're done with what
Oh, with the Neuralink shit?
No, with your, with the topic.
Uh-huh.
So, I'm going to play it.
Mm-hmm.
Back in your life after a breakup, there's one...
What do you think about this?
To come back in your life after a breakup, there's one golden rule. There's one golden rule. If she hasn't been with somebody else, you can think about taking her back. I mean, sometimes the distance heals you. And it actually makes you come closer. And, you know, through that process of separation, you realize that you did things wrong and she did things wrong. And you can come together and say, hey, look, we got to work on each other. But if she was with another guy, I'm not telling you that you can't take her back. I'm not trying to insult you. I'm not trying to disrespect you. But you're ultimately going to be hurting yourself. And I'm telling you this with love. Because you've got to understand that she was out there doing this, that, and the third with this individual. She was engaging with him in a vulgar manner. She was doing everything that she did with you with this person. It should make you pissed off. It should kill you inside. It should make you look at her like, oh, like I can't believe that she did that. You know what I mean? Because here's the thing. Like, if you take her back, you will never trust the relationship again. You will always be angry. You will think about, you know, the things that you did. You will question it. You will say, did you even like it in the first place? How did you get with this guy if you didn't like him? I'm sure that you liked him. And she says, oh, I didn't like him at all. And you'll say, oh, so I have to be worried about guys you don't like now? I have to be worried about things that you don't really care about and you didn't engage in them? Like, it never stops. You'll always fight with it in your head. You'll become obsessed with the idea. It's very dangerous for yourself. Sometimes when there's a lot of space and a lot of distance, like, you can really think about it, but it's rare that that happens. And it's, you know, very seldom that we come back to people after years. But if, you know, they separated from you and they went with other people and they did this, that, and the third, and they opened your home up to somebody else, it's no longer your home. You know, it's no longer yours. It's something that you have to let go of and really wish them the best. This is just my advice. This is just my opinion. You can do whatever you want, but I don't want you to end up hurting yourself over your lust, over your emotions, over your...
What do you think?
Oh, man.
So let me break it down for you. So I was looking at this and I started thinking about if it happens between me and, like, me and Lydia, right?
Mm-hmm.
I kind of think like, to, I'm gonna give you my opinion and then you give me yours.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's kind of wrong, right? Because at the end of the day, every time you get along, when you get with a girl or a guy, those people already have past relationships.
Mm-hmm.
So if you really look at what he's saying is, like, if you break up right now, right,
uh-huh.
and she goes with somebody else and you don't, and then she kind of realized, like, that person is not for me. Yeah, of course, she probably would have done things with that person.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, personally, I think I would take her back. And I would, maybe I would think about it, but it wouldn't bother me because before you got with your girl, she was with somebody else already.
Yeah.
Right? I can say I'm lucky because I'm Lydia's first.
Mm-hmm.
But if I hadn't, like, all of my past girlfriends,
right.
they already was with somebody and they already did stuff with him. Yeah. So what's the difference between that and that? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, what is the difference between now that I'm with this person and then we broke up and she went with somebody else?
Mm-hmm.
What's the difference between when we first got together, she was with somebody else and they already did things together?
Right.
So I think what he's saying is half of the thing is true, but I think if you think about those, it's because you're not, what's that word?
Self-conscious.
Self-conscious about mm-hmm. something about yourself,
mm-hmm.
right? Because now, what he said is like, oh, did you like it more than I did? Like,
right.
something, I would never ask that question, me mm-hmm. personally. I would have been like, you know, because at the end of this podcast, we like to talk about relationships, so.
Yeah.
I would never really ask about that. Like, did you have sex with that person? Mm-hmm. Like, because when you got with your girl, you didn't ask her, like, oh, like.
Oh, I did.
Oh, you asked?
I did, yeah. She asked me too.
Wait, did you ask, did you
about
like.
About past relationships and past experiences, yeah.
But did you ask or did you like it?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Okay, that's different.
She asked me the same questions too. And she the one brought up the topic.
So, okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, see, me, I wouldn't like to know that.
Yeah.
So, like, if, like, say me and Lily got together,
uh-huh.
like, just right now, I would have never asked that question.
I think.
Because, it would, like, kind of be like, oh, shit, like. Because,
mm-hmm.
I don't know what your girl, when you ask that girl, your girl,
mm-hmm.
your wife, when you ask her that question, and she said, yes, I liked it. Mm-hmm. I don't know how did that make you feel? Well, I don't know what the way, I don't know the answer, yeah, but I'm just saying, if she did say that, how would that make you feel?
All right. She told me, and this was more like on some grown up shit. Like, it was kind of more just being like yourself and kind of telling the truth. Like, we wasn't trying to hide anything. She told me about, you know, her past marriage and shit like that. Of course, it was good in the beginning.
Yeah.
Like, everything was good. They dated and, you know, they got married and shit like that. So she was like, yeah, everything was good in the first few years. I got pregnant and then, you know. She had her daughter, and then obviously things was on a decline because, you know, once you make a certain amount of money and you get the attention from women that you wasn't getting before,
mm-hmm.
things change, and then your woman don't look as as attractive as she was when you first met her. So she told me about that whole experience of, you know, his infidelities and, you know, going around with different women. So she said he became more unattractive to her.
Okay.
So that was the whole thing with her situation. Then mine, she asked me, like, what was your past relationships like? And I was just like, oh, just.
But did you, I'm sorry for cutting you off.
Yeah,
but did you ask her? Because what he is saying is, did you like it? Like, yeah. I don't know if, like, if she meant, like, what he meant. If he meant, like, did you like the sex or did you like the relationship? So I don't know, like, what he meant by saying that.
Yeah.
So did you ask her about any sexual stuff? Or? Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah. I've asked her, like what have you done? Because obviously my girl is older than me.
Yeah.
Right.
And No. I'm saying, like, yeah, you can ask that. But with, like, the conversation, like, what he was saying, like, when somebody leaves and come back and you take it back, now you're thinking, like, oh, did you like it?
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that? But.
Oh yeah, that's yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I would have never asked Libby, hey, did you like that? Because then, yeah, that will fuck with your brain. That will really fuck with your brain. Like, I'm like, what the fuck? Like,
I don't want to know that shit. Nah.
Yeah, no.
Like if we were together, like, prior to, you know, us being married now, like, if, like, we broke up and then got back together type shit, like, hell nah.
You wouldn't take her back? Oh, you would have never. Okay, let me go back to this thing. So. I'll say I would take her back.
Okay.
Because you said, like if what he's saying is, if you guys in a relationship, you break up, if she doesn't go with somebody else, he will take her back. But if she does, he wouldn't take her back.
Right.
So will you take your girl back, say that you guys break up today?
Mm-hmm.
She goes out with somebody else, and then break up, and now you guys are back together. I mean, like, will you take her back again?
Only if I was with somebody, too.
So if you were with someone, no, with nobody, you wouldn't take her back?
No. Hell no.
No?
No.
Why?
Because it's not like, because it's not mutual. Like, I didn't, like, all right, say she went off for 2 or 3 years and she had a relationship with somebody and I was just single the whole time. I decided, fuck it, I'm going to be single. I don't want no relationship. I don't want to deal with nobody. But, you know, if she was with somebody the whole time and then we got back together, then I'll be like, nah, fuck that. Nah, I feel like the rebound. I feel like I'm your comfort zone. Like, you came back to your comfort zone. Like, I still love him, but I'm not in love with him type shit.
But
okay, I got love for him.
You know
how
they say like, distance will make you realize. I don't know how
much you miss that person.
So, right? Like, where they say, like, you don't know how much you need that person until they're gone.
Yeah.
So, like, what that part, you don't think that's... that's on you that you didn't go out with somebody. Mm-hmm. Like, that's me thinking, like, that's on you. Like, oh, I don't want to
hook up with nobody
because I'm still in love with that person.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, you got hope that she might come back.
Right. Oh, okay. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
That you. That's why you still with nobody.
Damn. Okay. That plays a good role, because if I'm the one that fucked up, like, say I cheated on my girl and she left me and she went to another guy and then we were broken up and it's because I cheated. That's why we broke up and she with this another guy.
Mm-hmm.
But she decides to come back to me. Then I would be like, all right, I'll take her back, like, type shit.
Let's say that, like, you guys break up on a mutual shit, like, not cheating, nothing. Like, you guys just break up because it's not working out. Or you guys are fighting. You guys go your separate ways. 2 years later, you guys come back.
Mm-hmm.
But she was dating somebody for 6 months. Just say 6 months.
Okay. Yeah.
Will you take her back?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I personally, I would take her back.
Yeah, I'll take her back. Yeah.
I'm going to say it like this. If I still have love for that person, I'm going to take her back.
Mm-hmm.
If I don't have love, then I'm not going to take her back. Yeah. That's just not. But yeah, I will take her back no matter what she did with, you know, because at the end of the day, you guys are broken up. You guys are nothing. So she could do whatever she wants with her life.
Right.
You could do whatever you want with your life. Mm-hmm. So if it was my choice not to hook up with nobody because, like I said, I still have hope of me and Liddy getting back together, then that's on me.
Right.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, you know what? Like, I want to try something else.
Yeah.
that's on her. But then she cut, like, when she realized, like, oh man, like, I had a good thing.
Right.
I think I would take her back. Mm-hmm. And I wouldn't be like, oh, did you like the sex with that? I would never question that, because that's the past. Like, because right. if you keep go back to like the religion type of shit. If you keep focusing on the past, you would never fix the future.
True that. True
right? Because you can't never fix it. You can't fix the past, because the past is the past. Mm-hmm. Now what you do is fix the future, right? Mm-hmm. So I would never like ask her like, oh, like, was the sex better? Because she's probably going to say better. Yeah, because my dick is not that good. But she came back because now it's not all about the dick, you know? Even though that nigga could have a like 3 times bigger dick than me. But, you know, my dick, my little ass dick could do something.
Like, my girl is telling me she hooked up with like a 6'4 nigga, 6'5 nigga. I'll be like, fuck you, bitch. Fuck you mean. Yeah, I'm going to start crying. It ain't the same. You going to go back to a 5'5 nigga? Hell no. Nah.
Oh, shit.
You just with a 6 foot nigga? Hell no. Nah. Fuck yeah. All that. Yeah, so, I'll be hurt.
Oh man, So yeah, I was thinking about that the whole time. Like I heard that. I was like, oh, this is a perfect segment to talk about. Cause me, I would take it back.
Yeah, I'll probably take it back if it was like 6 months and not like a few years type shit.
Or man. What if like? So my uncle, I'm gonna tell you a story. One of my uncles broke up with, like, he cheated, mm-hmm. right? And the lady left him. My aunt left them. Mm. And maybe 10 years later, they literally like walked by each other. Like literally just walked by each other.
Yeah.
He turned back and was like, hey, what? And then they went on a little date. They went to get coffee. They were just talking about life. And my uncle told her, you know what? Since we left, I haven't been the same. Mm. They got back together. But the thing is, she already had a kid. Mm.
Yeah, that's difficult.
But she also said, like, you know, like, it wasn't the same, you know, because I was with you since ninth grade. Mm-hmm. They broke up after high school because my uncle was a dog. And now they're like, they've been together since then and have two kids my other cousin. Mm-hmm. I can say cousin. I grew up with him, so I can't even say step cousin. But my uncle took her back, like, I'll take you back. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, even though you have already a kid, live with somebody else, mm-hmm. but I'll take you back.
Right.
You know? Mm-hmm. And it's crazy because, like, at 10 years after you broke up and you still be like, yeah, I'll take you back. Mm-hmm. But my uncle's like, bro, like, that was like, I realized, like, it's again, we go back to the 80-20 rule. Mm-hmm. You know, like, that was like my 80.
Yeah.
The other bitch was my 20. Mm-hmm. And, like, the other bitch only had the 20. He shouldn't. So, yeah. I always, like, when I talk to my young folks, you know, I'm saying young folks because I'm a little older than the people I hang out with. Like, bro, like, always think about what you're going to do before you do it.
Yeah.
You know, because that person that you have at home, that's the person that's going to ride or die.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Lydia's my ride or die no matter what. Mm-hmm. And, you know, seeing him is your ride or die for what? For whatever, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I don't think Lydia will cover for me. Like, if I murder somebody, I don't think she'll be like, oh.
AB did it.
Yeah, right away. Like, that nigga did it. Like, he told me yesterday. Fold. Like, yeah, you know what I'm saying?
She gonna fold. Like,
because Lydia can't lie. Lydia cannot be a liar, bro. Lydia will fucking fold, like, right away. Lydia cannot lie for her fucking day of her life, brother. If I be like, even if I tell her, hey, I'm gonna play a prank on Mark. She was saying all wrong. Oh, I'm like, nah, you fucked up. But you know, that's my girl. So yeah,
she gonna rat you out. Like,
yeah, she gonna write me out right away. But yeah, you know what I'm saying. So I would definitely take her back. Uh-huh. What do you think?
Yeah, I'll take my girl back after if it's been so long and she had a kid or I had a kid and we come to an agreement and we take each other back, then I'll be able to do that. Yeah.
I mean, and for that guy, man, like, I thank you for the topic. Mm-hmm. I just don't think, like, any guy, me personally, I wouldn't ask, like, oh, how was the sex or how was this? Like, no, hell no, because that would hurt your friend. Yeah, that would hurt your manhood.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, oh, yeah, that nigga was fucking me like this. He'll pick me up. I'm like, damn.
Yeah,
so now you
want to
compete with the nigga, but you only can last 2 minutes. So you can't do that shit. You can do it every 5 seconds, you switch spots. You know what I'm saying? So, that, no. So. guys, what I want to say is, if you have if you want to hear how can I say it? If you want our advice,
yeah,
just write us down. We'll talk about it and give you an advice. So if you want the intervals advice, because we had one last week, just write it down in the comment. I mean, or on Instagram or something, DM us. Mm-hmm. We don't. If you could or say your name, we could. You just put it on the message or whatever. You can talk about my name, but if you don't, we don't have to talk about your name. I would just read it. We'll give you our advice, and that's how we will close every episode from now on. I feel like every episode should we end it with a relationship thing, because me and you are married, so I've been out the game for a minute.
Mm-hmm.
You
about 4 or 5 years now.
You've been out for 4 or 5 years, so us being in a relationship and married for, I've been married with my girlfriend was 15, 16 years.
Shit, this year will be 3 years. I'll be married.
3 years already?
Yeah.
No fucking way.
Yeah.
3 years?
Well, no, 2.5. 2.5. We got married December 2nd. So it'd be 2.5, actually. Yeah.
This year will be
2 years.
2 years?
Yeah, 2 years, yeah.
Okay,
this year would be 2 years.
God damn, that shit.
Yeah, this year would be 2 years.
This,
yeah.
Fuck, bro. This year will be, I want to say, 7 or 8 years. I got married 2016.
Mm-hmm. 17, 18,
19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Yeah, 8 years.
Yeah, we got married in 2022. Yeah.
Yeah, 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah.
I already had Audrey?
Yeah, you had Audrey already, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Damn.
Yeah,
I remember
you had
going
Audrey.
To a wedding, but...
Yeah,
I think I left it with my mom. I left her with my mom.
Yeah, you did. You did. Because I remember you said you was going to be late, and then y'all drove out to Temecula. Yeah. Huh?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. But, guys, if you guys wanted me and Mark's advice, let us know in the comments below, or DM us, me or Mark, let us know, what you guys want to hear, what advice you want us to. And it could be anything. It doesn't have to be relationships. It could be anything.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So.
Just throw them topics out there.
Yep. I think we said this was our outro song. I don't know if it was this one, but
this one's dope.
Yeah, this is like a chill, kind of close the episode.
Uh-huh.
You feel me? You know?
Yeah.
General, get into the rap vibe. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
if I would take my girl back, I would take her back. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Here we go.
Close it out, AB.
Let me think about something.
Uh-huh.
We have my boy Tim in the motherfucking house. We talk about fucking football and sex life. Now the Dolphins gonna go and win the Super Bowl.
Uh-huh.
And
we ain't rappers, but we doing this shit every day. Shooting podcasts on the way to the studio in the Bay.
Woo!
My nigga AB from the Bay. He get hyphy all day. Close it out, AB.
Woo. Hey, I go by every motherfucking Cuban with a P and an R at the end.
Uh-huh.
If you follow me on Instagram, it'll be nice.
Rappers come in the booth, man. We got y'all, man.
Yeah.
Come spit some shit.
Come spit some shit, guys. You know, we try to make this little poppin' every off. Maybe we could do this every episode. At the end of the episode, we just like freestyle.
We're going to be freestyling all.
Yeah,
every episode.
Every episode now. Because we rappers, you feel me? But yeah, if you don't follow me on Instagram, it's ABCuban to the motherfucking PR. If you don't follow me on TikTok, it's ABCuban_PR.
If you don't follow me, man, it's on TikTok, IMSGood1. If you don't follow me on Instagram, it's IMSGood. It's all one word as well. On Snapchat, follow up. We're posting all the latest content in the Woods Podcast, your favorite podcast in the IE, man.
In the IE, baby. If you don't follow the podcast, it's In the Woods Pod. Make sure you guys tap in on everything. Instagram, TikTok, on YouTube. Let me go back up. On YouTube, it's on In the Woods Pod. In the Woods, make sure you guys tap in. Again, your favorite host, AB motherfucking Cuban.
It's your boy, I Am Good, and
we
out
of here. Stay blessed. Be blessed. One love.
Peace.